By the end of this tutorial, you will know exactly how you can use date and time functions inside Integromat. So those are these functions over here. So you can, for example, have a time, and then you can add seconds to it, add minutes to it, add hours to it, or if you want, you can even format it to a completely different format. So let's just dive right in, and then we'll show you exactly how all of these functions work. So over here we have a new scenario, and this scenario starts with the webhook module. So this scenario starts whenever the webhook gets data, and in this case that is from a tool called Postman. And with Postman I can basically just send some fake data over to Integromat to show you these examples. So for example, I want to send over the first name, last name, email address, then someone's birthday and the date that they subscribe. So this is maybe coming from an email service provider, and what I want to do is I want to play a bit around with these two dates to show you some examples. So then this webhook starts, and then we go to the next module, and in this case that is a set variable module. So it's basically just a function module inside Integromat. It's native there, and it basically just allows you to set your own variable. But what I'm about to show you works with any kind of module. You can do this in every module. You just click inside the field in your module what you want to do. Then you go over here, you go to this little calendar, and then over here you find the date and time functions. So you have two variables. You, for example, have the timestamp, and the timestamp is a Unix timestamp, and it gives you the number of seconds since midnight, January 1, 1970 GMT. So if I just only put in this, I click here, okay, run this module only, then over here we get this amount of seconds. Now then you also have the now one. I think this is one is a little bit more practical. So here now gives you the current date and time. And click here, okay, run this module only. And then you see over here that we get the 17th of March 2021, 15 minutes past 1 p.m. So that's when I'm recording this tutorial. And then what I can do is I can manipulate these variables, for example. So here you see that we have at seconds, at minutes, at hours, at days, at months, at years. So we can have this now variable, and then we can add some time to it if we want to. So for example, what I like to do is to sometimes add days. So for example, if you would do an evergreen limited time offer, so you do some kind of marketing promotion and say like, hey, this offer is valid for the next 3 days, then I want to know the date in 3 days. So to do that, I just say, okay, I want to add days to now, then we have this semicolon, and then for example, I want to add 3 days. I click here, okay, run this module only, and then you will see that here it says the 20th of March 2021. So it added exactly 3 days. Now the other ones work exactly the same. So for example, if we would want to add hours, then you can also just say here, now I want to add 10 hours here, okay, run this module only, and then you see here that we have a time 10 hours from now. And it works also the opposite way, by the way. So it's a little bit confusing maybe, because here it says add hours. But if you type a minus in front of this 10, then you can also subtract hours. So here, run this module only, and then you see over here that we go back 10 hours. So then here it says 17 minutes past 3 a.m. So you can also do it like that, and obviously you can also combine these things. You can also end at days and at hours if you would want to. Now then, if you want, here you also have set seconds, set minutes, set hour, set day, set date, set month, set year. I have to say I'm never using these. I don't find these so handy, but maybe you have a cool use case for it. So that's how you do that. What you can basically do with it is you can say, okay, here I have now, right? And then we can replace basically the second, the minute, the hour, the day, the date, the month, or the year. So if I would say here, set year, and here I would say now, then I could say here, okay, we're setting the year, let's say 2025, click here, okay. And then you see when we do that, that we get the current date still, but it replaced the year. So here it says 2025. So that's how you use all of those. They all work exactly the same, but then with other ones like seconds, minutes, hours, and so on. Now then we have format date and parse date. Maybe these are the most complicated ones, but you really have to know how these work, because sometimes you get a date and time into Integromat that Integromat doesn't understand. Let me give you an example. So here, I just put nothing for now. I click here, save, I click here, run once. And then we're going to send over the birthday and the date subscribed, right? So here, I click send. And then go back over here and then you see that we got the data here. Emma, Doe, and then here, the birthday. Now, what I want to do is I want to understand what the 12th of February 1993 is, right? So that's my birthday, but Integromat has to understand how that structure works, basically. Because right now, if I would say here, for example, here, I want to add, for some reason, 3 days to my birthday here. If I do this now, I go back, I send data, then you see that we're going to get an error right here. It says operation failed with an error. Then if we go over here, then it also says 12th of February 1993 is not a valid date. So to make sure that Integromat understands this date, we have to parse it. Now that sounds very techy, but it's actually very easy. What we basically do, we go over here, we say parse date, and then here they also give some examples. So you have your date or maybe also time inside the first part, and after the semicolon, you tell Integromat what kind of format that is. So here, if I say now, okay, we have here birthday, then we have to type something that they call tokens. I'll show you. So tokens. I have this page also under a hotkey because I go here so often. And then you see that we get all the tokens for these things. So for example here, DO means the 1st, the 2nd, 30th, 31st. So here, day of the month, which, or Dino, not sure how you pronounce that word, but that. And then for example, if we would want to have the year, the full year, then we want to use Y, right? So we have to enter these things. So here you see that we have 12th. So that is D-O, right? You see here, D-O is the day of the month with this word that I cannot pronounce. And then we have here just a word, of. And then we have the month name, right? That's the full month name. And that is here, full month name. So we need this M-M-M-M. So I just paste that in here and then space. And then here we have the year, which is Y-Y-Y-Y. Right over here we have the 4-digit year Y. And then it should understand how this birthday text is structured so that they can actually do something with it. So now just click OK to test it. Click here, save, I click run once. We send data again. I go back over here. And now you see that we did not get an error. And now here it also you have like this format that Integromat works with. So now if you would want to, so for example here, we could say, okay, I wanna add days, right? For example, I wanna add 3 days. I wanna click save, click run once, and then here send. And then we go back over here and then you see here, okay, we got the data. And this is what came out 15th of February. So it added 3 days. So that is basically how you use that one, parse date. And then another one that I use really often is format date. A format date allows you to format one date to another. So for example, if we say format date, I want to format the current day, basically the current date. So here now, and I want to format this to the name of the day of the week. So to do that, we go over here and then you see over here that we need D, and then not capitalized, and it will give us the day name. So if I do that here, D, click here, okay. Then run this module only, and then you see that we see today is Wednesday. And you can also do this with other things, right? So for example, if I paste this in here again, so we parsed my birthday, and then we told, okay, this is that format, and we want to format this to the day of the week so that we know, okay, this is the day that person, in case that's me, is born. So here I click send, then we go over here, and then you see that I was born on a Friday. Now then, if you want, you can go even crazier, right? We can also say, okay, I want to format this not yet. I want to parse this, then I want to replace the year. So I want to set year, and I want to set this to next year. And then I want to format the date to DDDD so that I know on which day my birthday is or that person's birthday is next year. So here, send. And then you see that next year, the 12th of February is on a Saturday. So yeah, that's how all of these date and time functions work. I hope this is helpful. And if you like, I also have another tutorial about math functions. You can find those over here. And also another one about text functions, because I think it's really handy to know how all these functions work. And if you have any questions about this, just let me know in the comments below.